What's up? It's Rob from FLX with your first bi-weekly production update. More on that in a second. First, we've got a comment from Nihar. Can you intermittently share factory video updates for those of us who haven't received their bikes, if anything, to keep excitement levels up? Well, Nihar, we've got some factory footage for you today, so just hang tight. First, a quick reminder, we will be moving forward, staggering the lives and the production updates, you know, the long, mile long global status update, all that, staggering those every week. So this week it will be a production update, and next week it will be the live. The following week will be the long production update, and so on. You'll still get to hear from us every week about baby makers. You can still ask us questions on the live. However, it will allow our team to focus a little bit more resources on delivering the bikes and servicing the riders, which we see needs the most attention at the moment. So before we jump into the production update, let's check out a few photos from our riders in the official Babymaker owners group on Facebook. From Tommy, a gravel baby maker. That's looking really sweet. He's got the lights in back. Looks like a custom cockpit and a beer cap on the stem there. Really cool, Tommy. Enjoy the bike and ride safe on those trails. Next from DG, his Sterling next to what looks like a river or a lake. Looks really cool. It's a Babymaker standard Sterling uppers. Enjoy, DG. From Arturo, and we've seen quite a few of these, unfortunately, from the folks in Europe this week. Ordered it May 24, 2020. Arrived today in France after he had to pay some VAT, customs, etc. in France. And he says, after all the trouble, I'm not even sure if I should be excited anymore. And Arturo, we totally get the sentiment. You're not alone on that. We are addressing that this week. I will speak more to it in the challenge section. So please hang tight for that. And if you're in Europe and you just want to jump to that, it should be about 2/3 of the way through this video. So we're going to take a look at the factory footage before the global status update. If you've seen enough factory footage, you can jump ahead as well. And this footage is from our factory number one in China from about the last week of production. The footage in no particular order. Let's just go through it now. So these are some beautiful tangerine Babymaker frames. We've got bikes on the line here, some matte black pros with dropper bars here. Nice. Almost all the way through assembly. Tangerine Babymaker pros. On the right there, you do see handlebars. So again, those are all pre-built. Build all the handlebars, everything you can on those. Build the bike kind of separately and then add everything together. It's called a prefab. It's more of an assembly line. So build all the subcomponents together and then put those together for the final product. Here's some tangerine bikes on the line. Babymaker pros with droppers. And there we do have some uppers as well. So uppers and droppers on the same assembly line. These bikes are just about finished. It looks like they need the battery installed, finish some wiring, cabling, add the steering wheel, front wheel, and brake, and it will be ready to go. All right, some tangerine and matte black Babymaker pros in line here. Most likely awaiting inspection. And this is a tangerine Babymaker Pro. That is the cadence sensor on the bottom bracket there. You can see at least the cadence sensor passed QC, and then the whole bike will go through the factory's QC. By the way, all these photos and videos are taken from one of our full-time QC guys who is at the factory. He jumps between the two factories that we have in China. More tangerine Babymaker pros. Now a bunch of different color frames. We've got matte black, blue, raspberry, tangerine Babymaker frames. And these are tangerine Babymaker standards. You can tell from the chain there on all of these. So good to see those going through. Those represented only about 20% of the sales. So they are produced at a much less frequent rate. That's why in the footage, you almost always see Babymaker pros. However, we do still produce them all at the same time and just go batch by batch. Okay, some pros, we've got some base models. So doing our best to keep it equitable with the constraints of producing all of these bikes in mind. All right, bunch of, it looks like Halloween here with some tangerine and matte black Babymaker pros, likely awaiting inspection here, possibly packaging. More matte black and tangerine Babymaker standards with the chain there. We've got dropper bars on these, doing some cabling. And there we are. So you see the technicians there are doing some tweaks on these Babymakers that they have pulled aside. A sea of orange and black, tangerine and matte black Babymakers here. Those did represent two of the highest selling colors. Sterling was up there as well. This batch obviously does not seem to have Sterlings in it. So just the two top sellers apart from Sterling there. Now you see at the end here, these Babymakers are being prepared for packaging. You see the styrofoam tubing on it, zip ties. We've seen really good feedback about the packaging for bikes arriving in the US. and mixed reviews for those in Europe, UK. So that's something we'll be paying more attention to try and get the packaging standards there up to what we're seeing from this factory. Okay, we've got the brake rotors on a Babymaker Pro dropper, matte black, it looks like. There we go, some blue raspberry in line for packaging or inspection here. Behind it, you do see a bunch of Babymaker boxes in line there. The bikes, once they get all the packaging, they go inside the box. All the accessories are added, and then those are stapled, strapped, and loaded onto the truck. Some bikes in line being packaged. And there we go, we've got some blue raspberry, and it looks like sterling behind those on the line. That is a sterling standard. Awesome. We don't see those too often. Again, as standards were purchased much less frequently than the pros, but it's good to see them on the line and going out. More matte black Babymakers on the line. Again, this footage, by the way, was taken over the course of about a week. So if it seems repetitive, even after editing, our apologies. A lot of bikes are being built. This is the hydraulic reservoir for a Babymaker Pro with droppers. That's a mechanically actuated hydraulic disc brake. Here we have the Babymaker boxes going through the strapping machine. Put several straps on it just to keep that box together. Some sterling Babymaker standards completed, awaiting inspection. Look at that, we've got bikes ready to go here. Babymaker boxes, we have some standard bike boxes. There's a little extra space in this container, so there's even some Miles boxes with new Miles jetpacks coming. I believe this is C24 packed up, ready to go. And just loading these bikes into the container here. Super exciting. So those will be on the water very soon. They do have to do an export and then also the sea freight journey, come into the States, customs, go to FedEx, and then go out from there. All right, that's all the factory footage I've got for today. Let's see a couple more rider photos and jump into the global status update. This one from Scott. It's been a long haul, a year plus wait. The light at the end of the tunnel arrived. Had some issues here with FedEx, container tracking, et cetera, but finally got it, it's here. And even if I have to drag it up into the house the hard way, it's time to make a baby. Scott, enjoy your baby. From Kendra, here it comes, ordered August 16th, 2020. Got the FedEx driver pulling it up. I'm surprised how many people have caught their FedEx driver with the Babymaker box. That's just awesome. All right, let's jump into the global status update. Starting off in the US, C21, the SM Ningbo, that was 189 Babymakers, 220 touring kits. Those have all shipped. T7-1 Cosco Taizong, 225 Babymakers. All of those have shipped. T7-2, the OOCL Luxembourg, 225 Babymakers. 100 of those out of 225 have shipped. So like 40% shipped, not all of them just yet. T7-3, the OOCL Luxembourg, 226 Babymakers. That has started shipping. Only about 25 out of 225 have shipped so far. So close to 350 more will be shipping here, if my math is correct, throughout the week. C22, the CSEL South China Sea, 222 Babymakers. Most of those have shipped. There's about 50 bikes left out of 222. So that means 172 have shipped, if my math is correct. C23, Joseph Schultz, 221 Babymakers. Those are at FedEx now and being unloaded. So they have not shipped yet. They will be shipping out very soon. C24, we finally have information on that shipment. It was the container that you saw in the factory footage. That will be on the Cosco Pacific. It sailed July 24th, so 2 days ago, my time. 162 Babymakers, 21 blades on that. You can follow the production updates for more info on that container as it gets closer. T8, the NYK Themis, that has arrived and unloaded. 140 Babymakers and 50 out of 140 have shipped so far. The touring packages, 229 touring packages that we received are shipping right now. And we are currently sending out more address verifications for more touring kits for people who are receiving their Babymakers now. Hawaii and Alaska, same status there. Slight slowdown due to some certificates FedEx is requiring there for the overseas journey. So we're working on that. Should have that resolved very soon. All right, that brings us to the EU, UK, and the VAT situation. This whole fiasco, I will be addressing that in the challenge section. So please hang tight for that. But now just a quick update on what we've got outstanding. So containers NL4, NL5, which changed to SP8, SP9, and SP10. The EU portions of those containers, those were taken by cross-flight to backers in the EU. The UK portions of those have been shipping out from our warehouse in the UK. There still are a handful of orders in the UK awaiting the VAT payment. The vast majority have paid, but if you're wondering where your bike is, if you're in the UK, you received a shipping notification from us, please double check your email, spam folder, or get in touch with us. Again, that's if you received a shipping notification from us, but haven't taken care of the VAT yet. We can help you sort that out. SP11, there's 144 baby makers on that. That shipped from the factory on July 23rd, and the EU portion and UK portion of that were split up. Only the UK portion went to the UK warehouse. The EU portion we're hanging on to until we get some more clarification on this entire VAT situation in the EU. So we will have more news on that very soon. There is a container of components to build more baby makers. That's container 13 on its way to Spain. And that is due to arrive in Barcelona on July 29th. It will still need to clear customs. Cross your fingers for a smooth clearing, get into the factory, and then be used from there to build more baby makers. As far as the touring packages go for the EU, UK, we are reviewing with our tax professionals to make sure we have the correct plan moving forward as far as where to ship those, how to ship those, again, to minimize tax burdens for our riders. Next up, we have the low volume locations. Same status here as last week, however, with one update for Indonesia. Chris Link in Indonesia, this one's for you. We did just receive word there that the bikes are in customs there. I guess there's an issue with the customs system there and everything is just lined up. So it might be a little while, Chris and anybody else in Indonesia, for those bikes to clear customs and get to you. All right, that's it for the global status update. Now let's check out a couple rider photos from Lou. This is what it looked like the day I put it together. I've changed the configuration and it still rides like the wind. I call the bike Miles. Cheers, awesome Lou. Great looking Stirling Babymaker Pro with uppers. From Craig, oh my God, I am so excited. This just arrived in Philadelphia. Awesome, Craig, enjoy the ride. That brings us to the challenge section of this update. We'll be talking exclusively about the challenges with the EU VAT situation here. As you know from last week's update, we shipped 445 bikes to the UK. The intention here, guys, and always our intention, is to serve you guys, to get you the best bikes at the lowest final price. It didn't work out here, obviously, with the UK. So ship those bikes in, shipped them back, and people got slapped with big bills from the carriers, not just for VAT, but also for customs duties, etc. with those. And there were some errors as well. So the very first thing, last Friday, the logistics team sent out an email to these 445 riders, quite a long email, addressing this, what we're gonna do about it. And also following that email with a new invoice, which reflects just the bike and shipping price with no accessories, because no accessories were shipped with those bikes. So for anybody where the invoice on the bike does not match that invoice, you can use that to follow up with the carrier to hopefully get a more advantageous rate on that VAT. Also for the instance, I saw at least one of these where the VAT charge was more than the total cost of the bike. I'm almost certain that was an error. So you'll be able to take the invoice and compare it to the one they show you, or work with the carrier on that, on getting that result. Unfortunately, once the bike's cleared customs, they will not accept new invoices from us, the shipper, but they will sometimes work with the receiver on that. So that's why we sent all those invoices out on Friday. In the meantime, on this situation, we do have many things to go over with our professional accountants, who we rely on for professional, legal, compliance-related advice in the EU and UK. So because of the complexity of this, we've got multiple entities, multiple countries involved, bikes purchased in the US over a year ago, a lot of parts in play there. That is something that we need professional advice on. So before we ship more bikes to the EU, we do need some more definitive answers here. And also regarding the batch that has already shipped from the UK to the EU, we're waiting on the final word on that before we send you guys the next email, which I'm gonna tell you about here. So we have come up with a few options, some of which were suggested in the Babymaker owners group by people in the EU, affected people. So we have a few incentive options for you guys as a bit of an apology for the screw up there, shipping those bikes to the UK and then back into the EU. The extra fees that were a result of that, the customs duties, et cetera, the weight on the bikes, that's entirely our fault. That was based on our poor decision. So we will have something to make it up to you guys We will not be able to pay the VAT for these bikes. Again, that's something we've laid out from the very beginning of this campaign, that any additional taxes, et cetera, those are the responsibility of the buyer. So these are some examples from other campaigns about the VAT and customs fees. Again, these are Indiegogo campaigns. The reason why you see this on so many campaigns is because these are companies like ours with an idea to produce a new product, a baby maker, whatever it is. We produce it and I get a lot of interest from people internationally. The baby maker, especially, we did get a lot of interest from the EU. People say, hey, can we buy it? Sure. These companies say, yeah, absolutely. But there's no way for a small company to know definitively the tax requirements in every single country. We're talking about over 200 countries around the world before they've even built the product. That's why you see so many of these campaigns that at least have the foresight to think about that. We'll all list somewhere in the FAQ that if there are any additional VAT or customs fees due on the product, that will be the responsibility of the buyer. And ours was no exception. We listed it very clearly in the FAQ from the beginning. So here's some examples from other companies. Taxes and duty not included in the Indiegogo price. Is VAT included? There will be added local VAT and duties on their Strom City bike. Do I have to pay VAT? Backers are responsible for import duties and taxes. Refer to local customs office. For an A-ride, probably a bike as well, the customer is responsible for any potential duties or VAT. So our campaign was no exception to this. We did list in the FAQ who is responsible for any additional taxes, duties, or VAT. The backer is responsible. Please check your country's import duties before purchasing. It is 0% in the US and varies internationally. Again, that is something that we put there because at the time of launching, there is just no way for us to know the tax implications around the world with definitive clarity. So pretty much every campaign does do that. And if anything does come up after the bike is sold, that is the responsibility of the buyer. So just to clarify a couple of things, we did not advertise the Babymaker initially as being free of VAT or any duties. We did not advertise the price as being inclusive of that VAT either. Again, we are a US company. We're doing our best here and have the best intentions here. We're building these bikes and shipping them to you with all of the information that we know at the time of launch. There have been a couple of riders that have reported that they received from our support department or a comment on Facebook, a message saying that, hey, there's no VAT due in Europe, etc. Those messages I have looked at and they are from well after the campaign ended. They were in error as we were ill-advised on that UK deal. However, they were not the reason, I believe, that anybody purchased the bike. But these were from messages that were sent this year, only after those bikes were shipped to UK, for example. I saw one of those messages. It was in June of this year. So well after anybody made their purchase, with the language on the Indiegogo campaign about the VAT not being included in the purchase price. The only reason I bring all this up is just to clarify a bit of the remorse. It's not like we're trying to bait and switch anybody here. There was a mistake in sending bikes to UK, which did result in extra fees. And for that, I hugely apologize. For the miscommunications based on poor information from tax professionals that resulted in some misunderstandings in recent messages that were sent, I hugely apologize for that. And for all of the backers who were affected by this move to the UK with the extra fees, the slowdown, we are going to work with you guys to make this right. We do have some incentives to offer you. So you're gonna hear back from us probably this week with a couple options for you. It's not gonna be paying the VAT. However, we do have some options for you. So please hang tight for that email. Once we do clarify a few final things with the tax professionals, you'll be hearing from us. On that note, the next 85 bikes to the EU, we are hanging on to those as well until we do hear from the tax professionals, because we don't want a repeat of the mistakes made last time. It looks like VAT will likely be due on those as well. However, we will avoid the customs duties, the import, et cetera. So we're working on a plan for those once we hear back from the professionals as well on that. So with this, I want to thank everybody for giving us the benefit of the doubt. Again, we are here to build you guys the best bikes. We're not here to throw anybody under a rug or scam anybody. We've delivered over 90% of these bikes. I know it's been a long haul to get to this point, but nobody from the team is intentionally misleading you. Some mistakes do happen. We were given some bad information acted on that, and unfortunately it didn't work out in our favor, but we will make it right to you. So please hang tight for our next email on that. All right, that's it for the challenge section today. A work in progress, as we will be following up with those riders affected by email. So hang tight on that. And let's end this with a few rider photos from John. Nice match. He's got a Sterling Babymaker Pro with droppers to match what looks like a Porsche. Very nice, John. From Deborah, I broke the 2,000 kilometer mark this week. Woohoo, love my baby. I wonder where she's at, Australia, Europe, using kilometers, very nice. And from Rob, thanks FLX crew, no problem with assembly, went on a 3 mile ride tonight, very nice. Thank you everybody for the Babymaker photos. Please ride safe out there, be smart, keep your distance, don't break your leg like me. Thank you everybody for the patience and support. This has not been the most perfect campaign, but we have done our best and shipped bikes as quickly as we could in the climate that we are in. So thank you all for your patience. We will continue shipping bikes. We're almost there. The light is at the end of the tunnel. And stay tuned for the live next week and the next production update, which will be the following update. If you enjoyed this one, like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.